Hello. In this video, we will go over the backup throttling feature in PowerProtect Data Manager 19.14. Backup throttling enables us to pause backups on the target host when set in order to avoid resource contingency issues. Enabling backup throttling can reduce backup throughput and results in a longer backup window. For that reason, it is important to plan accordingly before setting the throttling limit and enabling the backup throttling feature. To start the demo, let's log in to the PowerProtect Data Manager application and review the application agents. We can see a new column added which reads Throttling. This feature is supported only for application agents starting from version 19.14. We'll use the server win-01 and set backup throttling for it. Select the server, click More Actions, and then enable backup throttling. Now we'll set a CPU utilization limit. For this demo, let's set the limit to 80%. The recommended limit is 85%. Now let's create a protection policy to back up the assets from the host win-01. Select Protection and Protection Policies, then click Add. After specifying a policy name and a description, we'll give the new policy the type File System and click Next. Set the purpose as Centralized Backup. On the Assets page, select the assets C drive and E drive from the host win-01. Now let's create a simple backup schedule with a backup frequency of 8 hours and a retention period of 5 days and click Save. Review additional options and click Finish to complete the policy configuration. At the bottom of the screen, we click View Details to monitor the system jobs. We can also now see a job for the backup throttling configuration. Let's check the details to confirm the throttling set. After checking the values, we wait for the policy configuration jobs to complete. Meanwhile, let's also check the CPU utilization on the Windows server. We can see that it is ranging between 5 and 9%. After the policy configuration jobs complete, let's trigger an ad hoc backup for the assets using the protection policy we created. Select Protection and Protection Policies. Select the protection policy File System Backups and click Protect Now. Select all assets and go on to click Protect Now to trigger the backups. And again, we can click View Details to monitor the jobs in progress. Click the backup job ID to list the backup tasks. Let's check the details of the backup job for the C drive and examine the CPU utilization on the server. We see that the backup job is progressing normally when the CPU utilization is less than the threshold set. Let's now put some stress on the Windows server using the CPU stress application. From the desktop, we launch the CPU stress application, add the CPU threads, then activate them. Now we see that the CPU utilization is above 90%. Back in Data Manager, let's closely monitor the backup job. We can see that the backup job is not progressing now. Now that we have confirmed that the throttling has affected this job, let's kill all the additional workloads on the Windows server one by one. We can observe that the CPU utilization gradually reduces to lower than the threshold. When we switch back to the PPDM Job Monitor console, we can see that the job is progressing and completing successfully. Thanks for watching this demo of the backup throttling feature in PowerProtect Data Manager 19.14.